Microsoft Fabric is the product that takes care of everything analytics for you in a unified platform. So everything from ingesting data to the data lake, all the way to delivering the information to the business user, everything in between, we do it in Microsoft Fabric. And since you have the data all over the place, both in Azure and in Amazon AWS, we are going to try to bring it all together. So let's take a look.
Super.
So what we're going to do is we're going to start building a lake house in the Fabric One Lake. It's very easy. All you have to do is give it a name, press create. In a couple of seconds, you have an enterprise-ready lake house ready to go. Now, awesome. We can bring data into the lake house by using any of the 150 connectors that we have here, but we're not going to do that. We don't want to do data movement. So instead, we're going to use shortcuts. Now, shortcuts allows us to link into data wherever it is. So in this case, we have some campaign images that we are storing in Amazon S3 buckets. So we're just going to connect to the Amazon S3 buckets, point to the data that we have there, and within a couple of seconds, we have linked our lake house to the S3 bucket. And you can see here all the images. We have a bunch of beaches that are next to our tails, and we can go and browse them, and here they are, right?
Awesome.
Now, we have more images. And I have them on my desktop. So in order to bring those images to my desktop, I'm using the Windows Explorer. So what you see here is that One Lake is like the OneDrive for data. So just like you have OneDrive showing in Windows Explorer, you have One Lake showing in Windows Explorer. And inside One Lake, you can see the workspaces that we have, the lake houses that we have. You can see this is the marketing campaign asset lake house. We can see the beaches that we have there in Amazon S3. And we can bring in more information. So these are the activities we're going to offer to our visitors. So I just drag and drop them into the file section of my lake house, and I have more images showing up here. And now we can see another activity, like visiting the volcano.
Super.
Now, to do the analysis, we need tables. And we're going to use the shortcuts again. So we're going to point to some Delta tables, again, we have in Amazon S3. And all we have to do is, again, connect, set the setting for those tables, and within a couple of seconds, you can see the tables show up here.
That's awesome. So we're not actually moving any of the data. We just have access to it no matter where it is.
Yes, it's just linked. No data movement whatsoever. Now, I don't have just data in Amazon. I also have data in Azure, in AWS, ADLS. So what we're going to do here, we're going to connect to the data, this table that we're managed by our Databricks, and now we have all the data, both from Amazon and from Azure, all coming together, and we can now start running queries across this data. So we are seeing here the data warehouse experience of Fabric. And we're going to write the SQL query, and this SQL query is joined data from tables in AWS and tables in Amazon, and it just runs.
Super. So cross-cloud query.
Cross-cloud query without doing anything. So easy. Now, most of our users don't know how to write SQL queries. So we are building them for them here, semantic models. And those semantic models include relationship between tables and measures. So the business users can use Power BI to just slice and dice the data very, very easily. So we have prepared the semantic model, and now we're ready to head to Power BI. So in Power BI, we have the Power BI Copilot. And what we want to do is to create this marketing analysis report. And all we have to do is tell the Copilot what is it that we want to create. And we give it the detail, like the ability to slice by the source of the customer and other things. And just like that, all we have to tell it, go, and a report is being created for us.
Awesome.
And it's really interactive, completely interactive. So you can cross-highlight, and you can filter perhaps by the customer source very, very easily. And so
I didn't even have to know Power BI. I
no.
just used Copilot to help create a Power BI dashboard.
Yeah, I wouldn't know how to create such a beautiful report. And it even changed, ask Copilot to change the layout for me. You can see two columns now that we have laid that out. Now, we can do even more. Not just laying out the data, we can also ask it for the main drivers for repeat customer visits, a more business-oriented question. And it will create a new page in the report, will put out AI visual, will tell us that if a customer purchases a spa visit, they're most likely to come back to our tail chains, which is kind of awesome. Now, let's go back to the original page that we had. Ask Copilot to change the layout again. And this time, we're going to point to another report, the sales report that we're using with our SLT. And just like that, it matches the styles of the reports. And it's still a completely Power BI report. So I can still have full control of what goes into it. So I can break it down by the customer interest.
Yep.
Or if I want, I can even change the chart type to make it look a little bit more snazzy. So let's make it into a ribbon chart. OK, that's nice.
That's looks much
nice.
Better.
Yes. Now, last thing I want to do, I'm replacing the last chart and ask the Copilot to give me the best highlights from this report. And just like that, the Copilot analyzes the data, gives me three highlights, complete with citations, and these highlights are always dynamic. When the data changes, the highlight will change. So just like that, we created an amazing report.